So in this video, I'm going to attempt something different. Up to now, all my creative coding was done in TypeScript on the HTML canvas. I'm starting this new series where I attempt to make generative art using Flutter. You might wonder what Flutter is. It is a UI framework from Google for cross-platform mobile and desktop app development. From the looks of it, it can create beautiful user interfaces. It seems to have a good documentation and support from Google, as can be seen from these short videos from Flutter team. They look like a fun bunch of people. Some people had used Flutter for generative art. For example, Robert Felker speaks highly of it in this video. As usual, I will be using VS Code for development. How to set up VS Code for Flutter development is well documented here in this webpage. I will leave a link in the description for you. It is very easy to install and set up, but will take some time. I'm not going to go through the setup in this video. Once you've set up, go ahead and create a project. Again, the webpage tells you exactly how to do this. When you create a project, Flutter plugin generates template code for a default application. First thing to do is to delete some parts of it so we can add our bits. Flutter uses widgets to organize UI components and uses composition over inheritance to create complex widgets. Here we are replacing the default UI widget tree with a custom painter. The custom painter allows us to draw onto a canvas, and it also has a UI widget on the same component. The painter defines the canvas we will be drawing to, and the child defines the UI widget tree if you want to have some normal UI components like buttons and sliders. Flutter plugin makes things easy by generating code for us. Here we can generate the class MyPainterCanvas. There are two methods we need to implement, paint and shouldRepaint. Since we will be doing animations, which require repaint every frame, we will set it to return true. It's best we move this new class to its own file, so the code will be easier to manage. We can remove the annoying debug banner by setting this flag. So we are ready to draw something onto the canvas. We do that inside the paint method. Let's draw a circle. It takes three parameters: a center position, radius, and a paint object. We will draw the circle in the center of the screen and will have a radius of 100. The paint object tells how the circle should be drawn. For example, the color is set in that. Let's set the color to red. Nice, I love it. Konnichiwa, everybody. By default, the painter is a background painter, which means the child UI widgets will be drawn on top of it, as you can see here. If you want to draw on top of the UI widgets, there is a foreground painter you can set as well. But we are not going to do that here. Okay, great. Now that's done, let's create some particles. If you've been following my previous videos, you know that all my drawing is done with particles. So here, no exception, I will create a class called Particle with a bunch of properties like position, color, and its velocity. Small refactor here to move this class to a new file. If you are new to software development, do this type of tidying up frequently. It makes your code easy to read and maintain. So now I'm going to create a list of particles and then initialize them. The initialization is done in the initState method of a widget. Here I want to create an array with 10 elements. And I will iterate the array and initialize each particle. Seasoned Flutter developers will notice that this won't do what I intend to do, and I will fix that very soon. Here I am trying to assign a random color. In order to do that, I need to generate a random number. And then we set the speed and angle of the particle and its position. We need to pass this list of particles to my painter canvas, where they will be updated and drawn. So in the update section, I will make sure that the particles are within canvas bounds and also convert the polar velocity to Cartesian velocity, so we can quickly calculate the particle position. Honestly, it's a bit messy how I do this here. I could be more straightforward. I promise to do better next time. Okay, now let's set up the paint loop. Finally, let's run this. And we are slapped with a wall of errors. Who has time to read all that crap? So this is because of a null reference error. This is one of the deficiencies of Dart, where anything can be null. Nullability is improved in a later version of the language. But here, the reason for this error is that when we created the list, we allocated elements thinking that it will create those elements. But they don't get created. Instead, we have to use something called a generator, which will create the elements for us. Let's quickly fix that. So here we are. As you can see that the position of the particles don't change when we refresh. This is because the random seed is constant. Let's use the time since epoch in milliseconds as the random seed. Fine, that seems to do the trick. So now, let's try to animate these particles. Heading over to the docs to see how it is done. Animating things in Flutter is not as straightforward as in HTML Canvas. It requires a fair bit of scaffolding code. First thing to do is to extend our paint widget with a ticker provider. And then add the animation controller and the animation object to the class. They will be initialized in the init state. Animation controller needs the ticker provider as the vsync. And we add a listener function, so each time the ticker goes off, we can update our variables. Controller needs to be disposed, so we add that to the dispose method. And these boilerplate bits to keep the animation moving forward. And there you have it, moving bloody particles. So this video took a little longer than usual. That's because we had to set up the scene for the future experiments. As always, thanks for watching. And if you like what I create, please like, subscribe, and share. In the next video, I will explore some geometric experiments with Flutter Canvas. Tune in then.